Very proud to be here today to announce my nominee for Chief of Police. And from the reaction that I've had from not just the council members who are standing with me today, but from the other members of council, I know that I have made a good choice and that he will receive strong support from council in 2 weeks when he is formally named as Chief of Police. The best person to be the Houston Police Chief in my administration and to take us forward with the changes that I laid out during the campaign and I've talked about as mayor, making us more responsive to the community, a decentralized policing model, a more cooperative relationship with all of the other law enforcement entities in the greater Houston area, is Acting Chief Chuck McClelland, soon to be Houston Police Chief Chuck McClelland.
First of all, thank you, Mayor, and thanks to all the council members that are present here today. It is certainly a privilege and an honor, and I'm going to work hard to do all of those things that Mayor Parker just said that was her vision for the next police chief. This administration is going to be open, we're going to be transparent, and we're going to be responsive to the community.
One of the things I heard from citizens' organizations is they didn't see the chief, they didn't know the chief. This is a chief who came up through the ranks, he knows his way around the city, he's intimately familiar with every neighborhood in the city, and he will be out and accessible. He's going to become a very recognizable figure.
As you take this job, what's your number one concern, your number one obstacle that lies in front of you?
Well, actually, there are three that I have outlined. One is strengthening those police community relationships. Two, improving the internal communication processes inside the organization and being more efficient with our processes and resources. So those are the three points that will frame my administration. We're going to do a better job of utilizing the technology that we have, our 24-hour real-time crime center, and we're going to be able to target our resources more efficiently and rapidly than we have in the past. Two, we have to encourage private property owners to invest more in technology, video surveillance, those type of things, crime prevention through environmental design. We also have to expand the use of technology, such as license plate readers, more video surveillance, more photo red light enforcement, anything that is a force multiplier that stretch our resources a little further in these financial challenging times. We have to do that. You know, nothing is off the table. We have to look at every option that we can to save resources, save money, and also, but still, fulfill that responsibility of keeping this city as safe as possible.
Thank you for being here, and let us salute again the new chief. Appreciate having you.
Thank you.